Did you know that the guy who created JavaScript was also a co-founder of the Mozilla project, the company behind Firefox? And then he went on to become a co-founder of Brave Software. What a small world, seriously. But you know what we're here for? Brave versus Firefox. Let's find out which is better. The only thing that unites these browsers is the promise of privacy and security. So let's see what these promises are actually worth. First up, is Brave browser safe? Brave is an open source browser, meaning that its source code is publicly available for anyone to check. This way, the community is involved in making sure that there is as little space for error as possible. Brave used Chromium as a base, the same thing that Chrome, Edge, Opera, and many other browsers are built on. But what sets it apart is the added privacy. Brave explains it in three layers. The first one consists of so-called Brave shields. They block potentially harmful scripts that could be used to inject malware, cut off trackers to prevent websites from gathering data about your activities, and also prevent them from identifying your device. Yet the best part of Brave is that it blocks ads. Yes, I've seen a lot of reports that it doesn't block video ads anymore. While I noticed that myself when using Brave browser for PC, I also have Brave browser for Android, and that still works very well there. Anyway, one more Brave shield is the automatic HTTP to HTTPS upgrade, which provides a more secure connection between your browser and the website you are visiting. The second privacy layer is called advanced protections. There's a whole list of them, from encrypting data when syncing among devices, to adding a private browsing window powered by Tor, which helps to achieve true anonymity online. The third and final layer is the core of it all, the policies and practices they have in place to safeguard user data by just not collecting it. Do you hear that, Chrome? How simple is that? All right, now, if we compare Firefox versus Brave privacy practices, they're not so drastically different. But there are some distinctions here and there. For starters, while Firefox web browser is open source, it is not built on Chromium. It's one of the last major browsers that doesn't use it and runs on an engine called Gecko. This gave Firefox a clean start, a base with already built-in safeguards against tracking and data collection. Your browser history stays on your device only. Well, unless you opt in to provide insights into your web browsing. And speaking of that, there are quite a few privacy settings you can change yourself, which is nice. Just like Brave, Firefox also automatically upgrades HTTP connections to HTTPS connections and has an enhanced tracking protection feature that blocks trackers and dangerous scripts. This feature has three modes: Standard as the default, Script for maximum protection, and Custom one too. However, the Firefox browser doesn't block ads by default. For that, you need a Firefox uBlock combo, or just get a VPN with an ad blocking feature. Those are super effective too. So yeah, as I said, in a Brave versus Firefox privacy matchup, the two browsers aren't all that different. But overall, Brave just has a little bit more to show in this area. From Tor mode to already building ad blocking, you know, it adds up. But which browser is faster? Well, I spent some time testing and comparing Brave versus Firefox in this area. Firefox used to be a so-so choice in terms of speed, especially in the early days, but then they upgraded their engine in what? Oh, 2017. Yes, and now it's fast and I've got no complaints. There are options to optimize performance too, like enabling hardware acceleration, managing Firefox add-ons, and guess what? Keeping the browser updated. Brave Internet Browser is also speedy, and its ad and tracker blocker reduces page loading times even further. Brave is slower when using private windows, but this makes sense since data travels through multiple nodes when using Tor. But if you're having issues, I found that keeping the memory save feature on can sometimes improve the speed. Also, whitelisting some of the most visited websites to stay active can help a lot. You know, like the CoolTechZone YouTube page, which you should totally be subscribed to. You are already, right? Right? Anyway, I don't see a clear winner in the performance category. Both options are good. So moving on, search engines. Well, Brave has its own. And while I saw a few statements that Brave search results are totally very biased and all that, I've personally never noticed this. And I honestly prefer Brave search over Google. Mostly because my first search result is, you know, the thing I'm looking for and not a sponsored link for some other totally random thing. But let me know in the comments if you've had a different experience. Oh, I also think it's cool that Brave's independent index is their own search engine index. So it's free from the influence of large tech companies. And then there's the so-called goggles, a customizable ranking system that lets you influence search results based on your preferences. Pretty cool. Just like Google though, Brave now has AI-generated summaries at the top of search results. Now, personally, I don't need this chewed up Frankenstein of an answer, whether it's Brave or Google, but I don't know, maybe it's just me, maybe some of you like it. Now, Firefox doesn't have much to show here. The default search engine is Google. However, you can use any search engine you want. If I were you, I'd change it to Start Page or SirX. That way, you won't get that many sponsored or SEO-optimized results. But yeah, Brave wins this round for just having something unique to show. And now we get to my favorite part of this Firefox versus Brave comparison. Features. Starting with Firefox web browser, I think it's one of the most customizable browsers out there, and it's very sleek and simple to use as well. In terms of features, there's the standard stuff like themes, and yes, you can get various add-ons and extensions, but one of my favorite tools is the picture-in-picture mode. You can just click this little icon whenever you're watching a video, and boom, it just floats around by itself, which means I can watch this and do other stuff at the same time. This isn't really beneficial for my attention span, but whatever. It's cool. I also like the PDF editor. It's a lifesaver. There's much more stuff, such as eyedropper tool for quickly identifying colors and a pretty decent password manager. I say decent because I still prefer NordPass, but it's still nice that Firefox includes this. Firefox VPN is also a thing, by the way, sort of. It's a separate product called the Mozilla VPN, but it's honestly very mid. And yet quite pricey. I wouldn't recommend it. Looking into Brave features, there's a Brave browser VPN as well. Is it any better? No, it's not. It only covers a handful of locations and doesn't have much to show in features. So the price they're asking for it is really brave. All right, moving on. Honestly, you're much better off just picking an established VPN. You know, like Surfshark, NordVPN, ProtonVPN, any of those will do a much better job and probably cost less too. I'll link a couple of options in the description. That said, there are way more features in Brave browser. Brave Talk, for example, is a secure video call for up to 4 people, at least in the free version. Or the Speed Reader. This handy tool removes the unnecessary junk from articles. Then there are vertical tabs, the Tor private browsing windows I already mentioned, and a Brave wallet for you crypto bros. And there's, of course, the Brave Rewards system too. You know, if you enable ads, you can earn BAT, aka Brave Browser Cryptocurrency. But the payouts are tiny. They can be as little as 0.001 BAT per ad. And one whole BAT is worth about 20 cents. Overall, I got to give this round to Firefox. I just found their features a bit more useful. So if we look at the final scoreboard, does Brave win? Overall, in my view, Brave is the ultimate choice for privacy, while Firefox is gonna be a great choice for those who want cool features and plenty of customization options. Anyway, I hope this video helped you pick a browser. Let me know by dropping a like and consider subscribing if you're not already. Thanks for sticking around, and I'll see you next time.